B'siyata d'shmaya, we're going to learn Shabbos Daf Kuf Nun Gimel. We're going to start on the top line of the Omid. Says the Gemara, Omar Rev Yehuda Bereder of Shmuel Bar Shilas Mishmeder Rav. It was said in the name of Rav, Me'espedoi Shel Odom Nikar Im Ben Oilem Abohu, from the hesped, the eulogy that is given on a person, one can see if he's a Ben Oilem Abo, Im Lav or not. How do we tell? If people get warmed up and they get moved by the eulogy and they cry, okay, that shows that he's a Ben Oilem Abo. But if nobody gets moved, and even when the hesped is being given, nobody's getting moved to tears, then that's not a good sign. Asks the Gemara, Eini, V'homa le Rav l'Rav Shmuel Bar Shilas. Rav said to Rav Shmuel Bar Shilas, Ochim Bespeda. Try to warm up the people when you give a hesped on me, says Rav. Dehosom ko'imna, because I'll be standing there. I won't be standing there. I'll be there. I'll be aware and conscious of the efforts that you put in to make sure that people are, you know, to see that you are putting in your effort to move the people and to warm them up. So you see from here that you need to put in a special effort in order to get people to be moved and for people to get to cry. And Rav was certainly a Ben Oilem Abo. And according to what we just said now, that just from without putting in any efforts, if people are going to cry, it shows he's a Ben Oilem Abo. If not, then not. Says the Gemara Loi Kasha. It's everybody agrees that, especially when an older person, however big and great he is, when an older person passes away, people are not naturally moved. When the person is giving a eulogy, is giving a hesped, then that's the big test. If people get moved, it shows he's a Ben Oilem Abo. If people are not getting moved by it, it shows that he's not. Loi kashya hod mechamulei v'ochim hod mechamulei v'loi ochim. If the eulogizer, if the person giving the hesped, the maspid, is trying to warm people up and trying to get them to be moved, and people get moved, then that's a sign these are Ben Oilem Abo. And if not, they're not. Omar le Abaye le Rabba, kegoin mar. Abaye asked Rabba, you Rabba, desonu le kulu pumpadisoi, all the people of the place you live in Pumpadisa, they all hate you. Why? Because he used to rebuke them. There were no small amount of issues in Pumpadisa, as we see in other places in Shas. Rashi quotes them. And Rabbi used to give them teichocha, used to rebuke them. And to the extent that there was some level of hatred between them. So, man ochim hespeda. Who's going to eulogize you? Who's going to give a hesped? And if nobody's going to be moved, that's not a good sign. Omer le. So Rabbi said to Abaya, Mistaya, it'll be enough for me, sufficient, if you, Abaya, v'Rabba Bar of Chonon, if you two give a hesped on me, that will be enough. Continues the Gemara, boy Menera Belozo Mirav, Ezo Ben Oilem Abo, who's a Ben Oilem Abo? Omar Le, he said, look in the Pasuk, v'oznecho tishmane, Tishmano dovor me'acharecho leimer ze aderech lechuboi ki ta'aminu v'chi tasmi'ilu. What does that mean? That means that when the people are giving a hesped, a eulogy on this person, and he says, look at this person, look at his ways, and you should follow his ways. When you're going to the right, you're going to the left, you should follow his ways. If that's what people are saying after a person passes away, that it's worth following his ways, it shows he's a Ben Oilem Abo. Rav Chanina Omar, Kol Shedas Rabbeinu or Das Rabbeisav Noichimenu. If any person who his rebbes were pleased with what they heard and saw in this person, that shows that he's a Ben Oilem Abo. Continues the Gemara. It says in the pasuk, V'savavu Vashuk Hasoiftim. What does that mean? B'nei Glila, the people of the Golil Omri, Asei Dvorim Lifnei Misoscha. Do things before you die. That means have a life, a productive life of Torah and Maisim Toivim, lifnei misoscha, before you get into the mitzvah, before you get put into a coffin, into the grave. B'nei Yehuda Omri, asei dvorim le'achar mitoscha. Do things to make sure, that means do things before you get to a place of being, again, le'achar mitoscha. That means the difference between Golil and Yehuda the one said lifnei mitoscho, one said achar mitoscho. And the Gemara says v'loy pligi, they're not arguing. Marki asrei umarki asrei. They were both saying the same thing. Do positive deeds in order that when it comes to eulogize you, then there will be positive things to say. One in the place called in the place of Golil, the person who was giving the eulogy would stand in front of the mito, in front of the orin, in front of the person, the dead person, and therefore do things lifnei mitoscha. Do things in your lifetime that when the eulogizer in front of you will have what to say about you. In Bnei Yehuda, they said, do things le'achar mitoscha. And the custom in Yehuda was that the person giving the hesped would stand behind the corpse. And therefore, they said, do things in your lifetime le'achar mitoscha, to make sure that the person standing behind you when you pass away will have what to say about you. Tanan ha'osom, we learnt, Rabbi Lezi Omer, shuv, do tshuva, yoim echad lifnei mitoscha, a day before you pass away. Before you pass away, make sure right before you pass away you've done tshuva. Shalu talmidav as Rabbi Eliezer, his talmidim asked him, v'chiyadam yedea eza yoim yomus? A person knows what day is passing away, he's going to die. Omer lehen, his talmidim said to them, v'kolshkein, even more so, yoshuv hayoim, you should do tshuva every single day. Shema yomus lemocha, maybe tomorrow you're going to die. V'nimtza kol yomov b'tshuva. And then you'll have the virtue of all your days being days of tshuva, of repentance. V'af Shleima Omar b'chochmosei, Shleima Melech in his wisdom also wrote this. And the pasuk says in Keheles, b'chol eis, all the time, yiu begodecho levonim, your clothes should be white, v'shemen al roishcho al yechsar, and oil on your head should not be lacking. Omar Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai, Moshe lemelech shezimein Esavod of Lesuda. This is a marshal of a king who invited his servants for a suda, for a meal, for a feast. He didn't tell them when the feast would be. Pikhin Shebehem, the wise amongst the servants, Kishtu es Atzmon, they adorned themselves and prepared themselves, V'yoshua al Pesach Beis HaMelech, and they were constantly waiting near the entrance to the palace. Omru, they said, Klum Chosar LeBeis HaMelech, there's nothing missing in the home of the Melech. It doesn't take any time to make preparations. At any given moment, the king could call us for the feast. Tipshin Shebohen, however, the foolish amongst the servants, Holchul Melachton, they went to their regular work. Omru, they said, Klum Yesh Suda B'loi Teirach, whenever you prepare a feast, it takes a long time to prepare. We have plenty time. We don't need to prepare yet. B'pisoim, and suddenly, Bikesh HaMelech Es Avodov, suddenly the king called his servants and says, come into the feast. Pikhin Shebohen, the wise amongst them, Nichnasu Lefonov, came in straight into the feast to the king, Kashein Mukushotin, when they've been adorned, and they're appropriately ready and dressed. Vatipshin, but the foolish amongst them, Nichnasu Lefonov, Kashein Mukushotin, they came in with dirty work clothes. Somach HaMelech Likras Pikhim, when the king came towards to greet the wise men, he did so with joy. V'kas likras tipshim, when the king came towards the fools, he did so in anger. Omar, he said, halolu, the wise people, shakishtu es atzmon lesuda, they prepared themselves and adorned themselves for the meal. Yeshvu, they'll sit, v'yoichlu, they'll eat, v'yishtu, they'll drink. Halolu, but the fools, shaloikishtu atzmon lesuda, yamdu, they will stand, yiru, and they'll just be onlookers. Chasnei shel Rab Meir mishum Rab Meir Omar. The son-in-law of Rab Meir said in the name of Rab Meir, Afhein nirin kemashamshin. They're not going to be very embarrassed of this. They'll be standing. That's what typically waiters do. So it will look as if they are serving the other people at the meal. And that's not very much of an embarrassment for them. Elo elu ve'elu yoshvin, the fools and the wise will be sitting. Halolu oichlin, the wise will be eating. Halolu ra'evin, and the fools will be hungry. Halolu shoisim, the wise will be drinking, valolu tzmeim, and the fools will be thirsty. Shenemar, as it says in the pasuk, koi omar Hashem Elohim, hinei avodai yoichlu, my servants will eat, v'atem tirovu, and you'll be hungry. Hinei avodai yishtu, my servants will drink, v'atem tzmo, and you'll be thirsty. Hine avoda yismochu. And the pasuk continues, Hine avoda yismochu v'atem tevoishu. The wise will be joyous, and you will be, the fools will be embarrassed. And then another pasuk, the next pasuk says, Hine avoda yoroinu mituv leiv v'atem titzaku mikeiv leiv. My servants, they are going to sing for the gladness of the heart, and you're going to cry from the pain in your heart. Dovar Achir, another interpretation of this posuk, B'chol eis yu bugadecho levonim, that your clothes should be white all the time, Eilu tzitzis, referring to people, they should be wearing tzitzis all the time, V'shemen al roish al yechsar, and the oil on the person's head should not be lacking, Eilu tfilin, this is the tfilin. Tefillin is called Shem, Kishem Hashem Nikra. The pasuk says, Kishem Hashem Roch Olam Oretz, Kishem Hashem Nikra Olecha. And the Gemara says in Brachos, in Megillah, it's Tefillin Shel Roish. So when it says V'Shemen Al Roish, Shemen means also the shame. Shame is referring to Tefillin. A person should spend as much time as possible wearing Tefillin Shel Roish. Hadron Aloch Shoyl. B'siyata Deshmai, we finished Perek Shoyl, we'll do Chazor on Perek Shoyl, and B'siyata Deshmai, we're going to start Perek Misha Hichshich. Says the Mishnah, Misha Hichshich Baderech, if somebody was traveling along the way on Erev Shabbos, before the onset of Shabbos, and he realized it was getting dark, and he's got in his hand a pouch which may have carried some valuable coins, and he doesn't want to just put it down and leave it there. He's allowed to give his pouch to a goy, and the goy can then take it to his home. But the Yisrael himself is not allowed to carry this pouch. He's traveling through Rosh Hashanah, and then he's taking it from Rosh Hashanah into Rosh Hashanah, into his home. There's something he's not allowed to do. Vim ein imoy nochri. If there's no goy with him, then manichoy ala chamoir, then he's allowed to place it onto a donkey. And we'll see in the Gemara that in the event that a goy is available, he should not put it on the donkey, he should give it to the goy. And we'll see in the Gemara why. And we'll also see under what conditions one's allowed to put it on a donkey. It's not clear at all that a donkey is allowed to do a malacha for you. Continues the Mishnah. Higia lechotzer hachitzayno. Once the donkey arrives at the very first courtyard in the city, at this point there's no danger anymore, there's no risk of just leaving it on the floor. When you're outside the city, if you're putting it down, somebody's going to steal it. But you're going to put it into a protected chotzer as soon as you enter the city. Then noitel es hakelim hanitlim b'shabbos. Then those utensils, those items and objects which are on the donkey that are not muktza, you can take them off the donkey and put them down. V'she'inon nitlin b'shabbos, but those things that are mukta and you're not allowed to carry and move on Shabbos, matir hachavolim, then you just undo the straps that were holding the ukuf, the saddle, and whatever was holding the packages that the donkey was carrying, v'asakin noiflin me'alim, and the sacks and any other valuables that were on the donkey will fall down on their own, and then you leave them in this protected courtyard until after Shabbos. Says the Gemara, "Mai tama shoru le rabbonon lemeisav kisei lenochri." Why did the Chachomim allow a person to give a goy his pouch or any other valuables? We know that you're not allowed to ask a goy to do a melacha for you. You're not allowed to tell a goy, carry this in Rosh Hashanah or carry this from Rosh Hashanah to Rosh Hashayochid. Why over here did the Chachomim allow it? Says the Gemara, Kimlul Rabbonon, the Rabbonon, the Chachomim, who had a very clear and deep understanding into the nefesh of a person, they understood that Ein Odo Maimid Atzmeal Momoinoi, it'll be very hard for a person to forego his money. Hiloi Shorislein, if you're not going to allow him, you're not going to give him some solution how he can save and protect and take his pouch and his valuables into a protected place, then it's comfortable to assume that he may well not manage to withstand the challenge, the Nisoyen, and he'll carry it for Amos in Rosh Hashanah, Chas V'Shalom. Says the Gemara, Omar Rava, Dafka Kisei, Avil Metzio Loi, it's only true
if it's his own pouch, and that's hard-earned money, and therefore a person will end up carrying it in Rishus HaRabim, even though it's Osir, he won't have the strength to withstand the challenge. But if you just found a Metziah, if you're walking on the street, and you find on the floor some valuable, then you're not allowed to carry it on Shabbos, and you're also not allowed to ask a Goy to carry it for you on Shabbos, and we can trust that Yisrael will not be Mechal Shabbos to save, to protect, or to save a valuable that he didn't work for, he just found in the street. Says the Gemara Pshita, what are you, Rava, coming to be mechadish to us? It says in the Mishnah, Mi shehichshich baderech, noisin kisay lenochri, is only allowed to give his own pouch. So the Mishnah already tells us, only if it's his own pouch. Says the Gemara, the Pshita kisay itnan. It says kisay in the Mishnah. Says the Gemara, no. Ma'u de teima hu adin afilu metziah. It could be that we may have thought the halacha is exactly the same, even with a metziah, with an object that you found on the street. The Haidik Toni Kisoi, the reason that the Mishnah mentions his pouch and doesn't mention any other valuables is Urcha de Milsik Toni, just because that is the most typical and common scenario will be that a person was going in the street, he was carrying his pouch of coins and he didn't realize how quickly Shabbos was coming in. Kumash Malon, so that's what Rav is coming to Mechadish to us, that that's not the case, and it's only if it's Kisoi, but if it's a Metziah, then you're not allowed to even ask a goy to take it for you. Says the Gemara, V'loi Omron, Elo de le'osi li'yode. This that Rava said, that if you find a metziah, that you're not allowed to give it to a goy to take to a protected place, to take home for you, is only true if you didn't yet pick up the metziah. And Rashi explains that you didn't pick it up before Shabbos. It means you didn't do a kinyan in it yet. Aval also liyode, but in the event that you've already, before Shabbos came, you've already picked it up, now it's yours. Once it's yours, kikisei domi, it has the same halachas as your own pouch, and the same way as you're allowed to save your own pouch, you're allowed to save this metziah, this lost property that you found. Ikud amra, others don't take it so easily for granted that Rava holds that once you have it in your hand, then you're allowed to kikisei domi, you're allowed to give it to the goy. And we're going to see, it's going to be a question, not a statement. Ikad omra, boya rova, rova asked, metziah habola yodei, mahu, a metziah, you find a lost property, and now you have a valuable in your hands, but you didn't work for it, you just found it. What's the halacha? Kiven da'osa liyodei kikisei domi, do we say that since it's already in his hand from before Shabbos, then it has the same halachas as his own pouch, and you're allowed to give it to a goy? Or maybe since he didn't work, he didn't put any effort into acquiring this coin, it's not has the same halachas as his own pouch. And the Gemara says, teiku, according to this second lashon, it's teiku, we have to let it stand, we have no way of resolving the question. Continues the Gemara, Ein imoy nochri, the Mishnah said that if you don't have a goy with you, you're allowed to put it on a donkey for the donkey to take with you. Says the Gemara, Taima de ein imoy nochri, it's only mutter to put it onto a donkey because you don't have a goy who can take it for you. Ha yesh imoy nochri, in the event that you could give it to a goy, le nochri loivle yohivle, you should give it to the goy to take for you to your home and not put it onto, give it to a donkey, put it onto a donkey. My tama, why should that be the case? Why should we give preference for a goy to do it, even though normally it's also to ask a goy to do a malacha for you, rather than putting it onto a donkey and letting the donkey do it for you? Says the Gemara, Chamoyer atamatzuva al shvisosi. That we're going to see later, but there's a halacha that you are not allowed to make your animals do malachas. You have to make sure that your animals also rest on Shabbos. Nochri yatomatzuva al shvivosi, but with a goy, you're not commanded to make sure that he rests. There's normally an issur d'rabbanon, you're not allowed to ask a goy to do a melacha for you. And therefore, if in the case where Chazal knew you have to save this pouch, you can give it to a goy, but don't put it onto your donkey, because you are required to make sure that your donkey doesn't do these melachas for you. Continues the Gemara, Chamoyer. If you have an option of either putting it on a donkey or giving it to a cheresh, somebody who can't speak and hear, a shoita or a cotton, a minor, or a shoita, somebody who's got no das, then a chamoyer monachle, he should rather put it onto a donkey L'cheresh shoyte v'katan lo yoiv lei, but do not give it to a cheresh shoyte v'katan. My tam, why? Hani odom, because at the end of the day, cheresh shoyte v'katan, they may be potur from mitzvahs. They may not have responsibilities and may not be have consequences for what they're doing, but nonetheless, they are odom. And since they are people, if you're going to let them do the melachos, you might think that other people are also allowed to do this, and you might give it to somebody or do it yourself. You might get confused between those people and those people, and therefore give it to the donkey. Put it onto the donkey. Cheresh v'shoita. If you have a choice between a cheresh, something you cannot hear, and a shoita, who should you give it to? L'shoita. You should give it to a shoita, because a shoita has no das whatsoever. And therefore, he's totally not present in his mind. And therefore, let him do it. A shoita, it's a cheresh, however, it's not so clear where he's got some level of das. In many halachas, we give him the same status as somebody without das, but he does have some little bit of das, and since he's got a little bit of das, better give it to a shoita than to give it to a cheresh. Shoita v'katan, if you have the options of either giving it to a shoita or to a katan, l'shoita, you should give it to a shoita and not to a katan. And why? And we'll soon see, because a katan is somebody who's going to come l'chlal das. We've seen previously, a katan, if you give it to a katan, he may end up doing the same malocha when he's an adult, and therefore rather give it to a shoita who's got no das whatsoever and will not have any das in the future, give it to the shoita. Iboilu asks the Gemara, cheresh v'katan mai. If you can either give it to a cheresh or to a katan, what's the halacha? So the Gemara says, Alibud Rebbe Eliezer, loiti boilucha. According to Rebbe Eliezer, I'm definitely not asking. There's no question. It's clear to me that you give it to a katan, not to a cheresh. Why? The Tanya Rebbe Yitzchak Oimer Meshum Rebbe Eliezer, Trumas cheresh, if a cheresh takes truma, loi seitze l'chulin. We don't say that it's as if a shoita took chulin and took truma, sorry, and it's totally invalid. We don't say that. Loi seitze l'chulin, it's got the halachas of truma, and a zor, somebody who's not a kohen, is not allowed to eat it. It's true that you have to take truma again, because it's a sofik, exactly to what level the cheresh has das, according to Rebbe Eliezer. But he's got some level of das, mipneshu sofik. There's a sofik how much das he's got. So therefore, it's clear that if you've got choice of either giving it to a cheresh or to a katan, give it to a katan, because the cheresh is a sofik that he's got das, and if he's got das, he's a gadol. He's not allowed to be mechal Shabbos. Ki teboy lecha libud rabbonon. We're asking according to the chachomim, who argue with Rabbi Eliezer, and the chachomim say that a cheresh has no das whatsoever. He's got the same status as a shoita, the same status as a katan. That's the question, who do we give it to? A libud rabbonon d'tnan, we learned in a Mishnah. It's a Mishnah in Trumas, the very first Mishnah. Chamisha lo yitrumu, there are five that should not take truma. Ve'im tormu, and if they do take truma, ein trumas on truma, their truma is totally invalid, and it's not truma, it has no kedusha whatsoever. Eluhein, who are these five? Cheresh. He says cheresh is one of them. Not like Rebbe Eliezer, who says, lo yiseitze l'chulin, that misofik, we do give it some kedusha. No, the chachomim say, aim truma some truma, on an absolute level, it's as if he's done nothing. Cheresh, shoita, v'kotten, because they don't have any das. V'hatoyrim es she'enu yisheloi. Or if you take truma on something that's not yours, you can't take truma on something that's not yours. This is learnt out from a posuk. V'nochri she'toram es shel Yisrael, or if a goy takes truma on behalf of a Yisrael, afilu b'reshusoy, even if the Yisrael gives reshus. Normally we know there's a din of shlichus. You're allowed to tell your shliach, somebody, to do it on your behalf. The din of shlichus is actually learned from here, from truma. But we learn from the psukim over here that only somebody who's similar to you, gam atem, a Yisrael, a goy, has no shlichus, and therefore, even if you tell the goy to do it and he does it on your behalf, the truma is invalid. Afilub Rashusay, ain't truma, say truma. Mai, so according to these chachomim, what's the halacha? Who gets preference if we have to somehow get this kiss, get these valuables to safe place? Who's going to take it? The cotton or the cheresh? The cheresh yoivle. The cotton osi lichlal das. Do we give it to the cheresh because there's a problem, there's a disadvantage of the cotton, is that cotton is going to become an adult and he's going to have das one day, and therefore we don't want him to get used to doing chilul Shabbos? Or Dilma, no. Le cotton yoivle, better give it to a cotton, d'cheresh osi lichlufei begodl pikeach. Because if you give it to an adult, even though he's a cheresh, you may get confused and think you can give it to another adult. And another adult, Yisrael, is his chilul Shabbos. Better give it to a little child, and everybody knows the child is not mechuyev, it's a chiyuv of chinuch, but he's not going to be chayev for Shabbos, and therefore give it to the cotton. That was the question. So ikad de omru lecheresh yoevle. Some said you should give it to the cheresh. Ikad de omru lecotton yoevle. Others said you should give it to the cotton. That means there were those who held of one side of the and those who held of the other side. Continues the Gemara. Ein shom loy nochri v'loy chamoyer v'loy cheresh v'loy shotze v'loy cotton. What do you do if none of these options are available? Not the most preferred one, which is a goy. Not the second, which is a chamoyer, a donkey. And not a cheresh shotze v'cotton. What do we do? At the end of the day, we're afraid that if you don't give him some solution, he's going to take it himself and save his hard-earned money, and he'll be mechal Shabbos. Omar Reb Yitzchok, oyd acheres hoyso. The truth is, we have another solution. V'loyrotzu chachomim legaloiso. The chachomim didn't want to reveal it. So ask the Gemara, my oyd acheres hoyso. What other solution is there that the chachomim did not want to reveal? Says the Gemara, Moilichoi pochis pochis midalet amas. We know there's a halacha, the only chayev in Roshus HaRabim, if you carry 4 amas. So if somebody picks up his pouch, walks 3 amas, and stops. He did an akira and a hanocha, lifted up, so to speak, he started walking and stopped walking, and didn't do dalet amas, he's not chayev. And then he does another 3 amas, and another 3 amas, and he does that all the way home. He's not been chayev min haTorah for Shabbos. Asks the Gemara, "Why lo yrotzu chachomim legaloisa? Why did the chachomim not want to reveal this way, this solution?" Says the Gemara, because we have a posuk. It says in the posuk in Mishlei, "Kvoid elokim." Sometimes to uphold the honor of Hashem, hastir dova. You should conceal certain things. You don't need to reveal everything. Kvoid melachim. But if it's just the covered of melachim of kings, then chakir dova, then you should investigate and you shouldn't keep things in the quiet concealed. So over here, there's obviously some kvoid shamayim that comes from not revealing this. Asks the Gemara, b'hocha, my kvoid shamayim ikah? Why do you think that it's better for Hashem and his Torah if you don't tell people this solution? Says the Gemara, dilma osi la'asuyei dalad amas b'shus harabim. If you allow a person to go 3 amas, 3 amas, 3 amas, he may come by mistake to do 4 amas, 4 amas, 4 amas, and then he's going to be chayev for Shabbos. And this is actually one of the Yud Ches Dvorim we saw in Daf Yud Zayin Amud Beis, that there were 18 gezeiros that they made in the attic of Hananya ben Chizkiah, and one of the gezeiros were that you're allowed to give it to the goy, as we saw in our Mishnah. But you're not allowed to take it yourself, dalad amas, dalad amas. They actually made a gzeira that you're not allowed to resort to this solution. And says the Gemara, Tanya, Rabbi Eliezer Oimer, boi bayoim, god shuso. On that day, that one day, where in the attics of Hananya ben Chizkiah, they made these 18 gzeiras, god shuso. If you had a container, it's a moshel. If you had a container holding a saw, and sometimes you can add on even more and it will just pile up, even though the utensil is full, just keep adding and it will pile up. On that day, they added gezeiros, they added more things that were preserving Torah, that halachas should not be transgressed, as we saw in the first in Daf Yud Zayin, Daf Yud Ches. So on that day, Gotshu saw, the saw actually got piled up. There was a big advantage with the gezeiros they made that day. Rabbi Yeshua Omer. Rabbi Yeshua argues and says, no. Boi bayoim, they made so many gezeiros, mochku saw. They had a piled up saw, and that day they actually leveled it out. That means they lost. There was some disadvantage. Torah actually lost that day more than it gained. Tanya, Moshel Rabbi Eliezer lemar dava doimer. Rabbi Eliezer said that day the saw got added up. There was some advantage here. Doimer lekupa meleo kishuin. It's compared to a box that's full of kishuin or diluin, different types of vegetables. Odom noisin, even though it's completely full of vegetables. Odom noisin letoicho. You want to add into it chardol, mustard seeds. V'imachzekes, and you can add and add and add, and there'll still be space for it. Moshel Rabbi Yeshua lemuad ova doimer. However, according to Rabbi Yeshua, what's the moshel? La'areva meleo dvash. there was a bowl that was full of honey. Noisen l'toicha rimoinim, you want to add on and put into it pomegranates, vegoizim, and nuts, v'him mekia, then the honey that was in it overflows and gets pushed out. That means if you're trying to add, you're actually losing. And the question, and over here, according to Rabbi Yeshua, Rashi explains over here, was this gezeira of not telling people they're allowed to go three amas, that actually created a disadvantage. Because in a case where you don't have a goy, a chamoyer, a cheresh, right of a cotton, a person is going to end up doing it himself and walking dalad amas. Because you've made this gezeira not to let them walk three amas. So they don't know about this solution. They said you're only allowed to give it to a goy, as we saw in our Mishnah. You have a pouch, give it to a goy, to a donkey, not more than that. So people don't know that you can walk three amas, or they're not allowed to do the three amas, and they'll end up doing the four amas, which is chilul Shabbos. Omar Mar, Ein imoy nochri manicha halachamoyer. We saw in the Mishnah, if you don't have a goy, put it onto your donkey, let the donkey take it to you. Asks the Gemara, v'haloi mechamer, that doing that, and how is your donkey doing this? Your donkey's following you. You're calling him on. You're telling him where to go. He's your donkey. He's following you. So this person, he's leading a loaded donkey. If you put your pouch on your donkey and then you lead it, which is what you're doing, you're not carrying the pouch, but you are causing the animal to move the cow, to move the pouch, then it's called mechamer. V'rachmona omar. And there's a halacha, it's learned from the pasuk, lo yisase kol melocha. It says in the pasuk, lo yisase kol melocha ata uvincho vitecho avducho vamoscho uvehemtecho, that you're not allowed to do a melocha. Not only are you not allowed to do a melocha yourself, you're not even allowed to do a melocha together with your donkey. And over here, you're doing the melocha together with the donkey. The behemtecho, you've put the pouch onto the donkey, and now the donkey is following you. You're causing the loaded donkey to carry in Rosh Hashanah. That's also asa. Omer v'ade ba'ava. Yeah, but when is it asa? Carrying Dalad Amas is only ever asa if you carry Dalad Amas, as we mentioned. You do an Akira, you take it Dalad Amas, and you do Anocha. Over here, we have a way of doing it that the donkey should always only be doing a Hanocha and no Akira. How do you do that? If a wilder animal is moving, you put it onto his back. And that way, it's not as if he's stationary. You put the pouch on its back and then it starts moving, then that's called an Akira. If while he's moving, you put it on, then you have a Havara. He's traveling with it. He's not actually lifting it. That's called that there's no Akira. And then it'll be okay. There's no Melocha d'oraisa. Manicha yolo kshim aleches. That's all very good if you can make sure that the animal's not going to stop on the way. But this animal is going to stop. He's going to stop to pass water. He's going to stop to move his bowels. He's going to have to stop. And then when he stops, he's then going to start walking again. He's going to do an Akira, go Dalad Amos, at some point do a Hanocha, and there's going to be an issue with Mechamer. Answers the Gemara, Kashima leches manicho yoleo. Make sure that you put it on once it starts moving, because then it's already, then there's no Akira. Or Kashio medes noitle meno. When it stops, it did a Hanocha, but so far so good. There was no Akira. A Hanocha without an Akira is not a deraisa. Now lift up this object from the Chamoir, wait till it starts going again, and only after it starts going, put it back on its back, and then again you'll have he'll be taking it for amas, but he will not be doing an Akira. Asks the Gemara, brilliant idea. Ihocha afilu chaveir einami. So do that the same with your friend. Why do you say you can only do it with a goy, with a chamoyer, a cher, a shreit of a cotton? You have a friend with you, a Yisrael. Tell him to start walking, put it onto his back, and then there'll be no Akira, and that way you'll have saved your parcel. Omer of Papa, kol shebegufoy chayev chatos. In the event that person himself picks up an object while he's moving, of course it's called an Akira. The fact that you're doing it in transit, that doesn't matter. Tachlis is, you picked it up now. It doesn't matter. It's only if your friend puts it on top of you, then it's not called an Akira. But if you do it yourself, it's called an Akira. And the rule is, kol shebegufoy chayev chatos. Anything that if you do it on your own, Yochayev chatos, chaveiro yipotor avel osur. Then doing it onto your friend or with your friend might not be a chiyuv deraisa, but it's osa. And therefore, since if you were to pick it up while you're moving, it's chiyuv chatos, you're not allowed to put it onto your friend while he's moving. Kol shechaveiro potur avol osur. But anything that if you put it onto your friend, it's potur avol osur. B'chamoyre mutar lekatchila. To do it on your donkey, you're allowed to do it lekatchila. And therefore, you're allowed to put it on your donkey while after the donkey started moving, but you cannot put it onto your friend's back. Continues the Gemara. Omer b'adu bar ava. What happens if a person from before Shabbos, he had his packages on his shoulders, he was carrying them, and it's now Shabbos. What should he do? So, rotz tachteo al shemagia lebeisoi. Then, since you did your akira from before Shabbos, you started walking before the onset of Shabbos, make sure you don't stop. If you stop, then you'll have a hanocha, and that alone won't be the end of the world, because you didn't have an akira. But if you start walking again, then you're going to have a akira and a anocha. So make sure you keep running till you get to your home. Dafka rot, you have to run. Why do you have to run? Abel kali kali, but walking slowly, loy. My time, why? What's the difference? As long as I don't stop, I haven't done a anocha, so I haven't done an akira. If I haven't done an akira, that way I can save my pouch without doing a chil deraisa, chil Shabbos deraisa. Why do I have to go slowly? Why do I have to go fast? Why am I not allowed to go slowly? Says the Gemara, Kivin de les lehakira. If you're running, then you're doing something that's constantly reminding you, don't stop. But if you go slowly, there's no heka, there's nothing to remind you. And therefore, osi lehakira v'hanocha, then you might, by mistake, stop, and then you'll restart, and you've got your packages on your back. Restarting is an akira. You're going to do dalad amos b'shus harabim, and that's osa. Ask the Gemara, soif soif. Okay, so you haven't done an akira. You're just walking. Now you've got to your house. You're going to have to do hanocha. You can't just barge straight into your house. That doesn't work. You're going to have to stop for a second outside your house. So as far as the Rosh Harabim is concerned, that's fair enough. You didn't do an akira. Okay. But now that you've stopped, you're not allowed to put it from the Rosh Harabim into Rosh HaYochid. Carrying from a public domain into a private domain is Chilul Shabbos. How are you going to get it into your house? Answers the Gemara, you're right. I've stopped, and therefore I can't. I've got an issue now. But the Zorik Leikalach HaYad, you have to throw it into your house from behind you. Turn your back to your chotz or to your home and throw it in backwards. Kalach HaYad in an unusual way. Doing a malach in an unusual way is only going to be an awesome midrabbonon. Toisus here asks that the same question that we had here, that there's a problem of carrying from the Rosh Harabim into Rosh HaYochid, then when we said before that one of the solutions, which the Chachomim did not want to tell people, but the solution of carrying your pouch, three amas, that's all very good till you get to the end of the Rosh Harabim. But how are you going to actually go into the Rosh HaYochid? You're not allowed to go from Rosh HaRabim to Rosh HaYochid. Tosfos says it's strange that the Gemara didn't take town with this issue then, but obviously the same answer will apply. When you get to the Rosh HaYochid, you have to put it into the Rosh HaYochid in an unusual way. Omar Romi Barchoma, Hamachamir Achar Behemtei B'Shabbos. If somebody is leading a loaded animal on Shabbos, B'Shoigig, if he did it unintentionally, Chayev Chatos. It's one of the malachos of Shabbos. It says in the pasuk that we read before, "Leisase kol malacha ato v'inchovitecho avdecho v'amoscho v'hemtecho v'gerucha shebishorecho." But maybe if you do it intentionally, chayv skila. It's like all other chilul Shabbos. You chayv skila. My tama. What's the source for what Rami Bar Choma says? Omar Rava. So Rava says, even though I don't agree with Rami Bar Choma, as we're going to see soon, but I'll nonetheless explain to you what the reasoning of Rami Bar Choma is. The Omar Kro, Loisase kol malocha ato uvehemtecho. We saw in the pasuk that we just mentioned, you're not allowed to do a malocha, you, etc., and your animal. Behemtoi, doing a malocha together with your animal is dumya didei, is similar to ato, doing it on your own. Mahu, if you carry this on your own, af behemtoi, if you do it together with your animal, which is mechamer achar behemtoi, nami b'shoigeg chayev chatos, b'meizit chayev skila. And Omar Rava says that was the source of Rami Bar Choma, that he compares the person doing it on his own to the person doing it with the animal. But Rava says shtei tshuvos b'davar. I personally have got two refutations to this halacha of Rami Bar Choma. Rami Bar Choma, who says two things. Number one, if you do it by mistake, if you do mechamer by mistake, there's a chayiv chatos. And if you do it intentionally, there's a chayiv skila. Rava says, I've got an issue with both of those. Choda, regarding the shoigeg bringing a chatos, the chsiv it says in the pasuk, Teira achas yelochem lo'isa b'shgogo, v'nefesh ashetase b'yod romo, etc. And this is a pasuk, we're not going into it now, but we've already saw this on Daf Samach Tes. We learn from here, Huksha kol ha'teira kula l'avodah zara. The conditions of ever being chayev chatos in the whole Torah are similar to avodah zara. The same conditions as the chiyuv chatos that is for serving avodah zara b'shoigig. Ma avodah zara d'ovid maisa b'gufei. Like avodah zara, you'll only ever be chayev chatos if you actually did a maisa, with an activity yourself. Hachanami so too regarding chilul Shabbos or anywhere else in the Torah. Abd Ovid Maisa Bagufei. Over here, he didn't do anything himself. All he did was he was calling the animal, he was making the animal travel, but he wasn't actually doing anything. If you don't do anything, there's no Chiyuv Chatos. Void. And regarding the Mezid, none we learnt in the Mishnah. Hamachale les Hashabbos Bedovar Shechayovin al Shigigosei Chatos Vaal Zedoino Yiskila. The Mishnah there refers to somebody hamechalilas Shabbos, somebody who did chilul Shabbos, bedover shechayovin al shigigosei chatos val zdoine skila. If he did the type of chilul Shabbos that the shoigig was chatos and the mezid was skila, .. You'll have a look in the Mishnah in Sanhedrin. Michlal, from there, from the language, from the tune of what the Mishnah says. From the fact that it says, if you did the type of Chilul Shabbos that there's Chatos and Skila, it seems from there that there's a type of Chilul Shabbos where there's no Skila and Chatos. Mind you, what Chilul Shabbos can that be that there's no Chiyuv Chatos by Shoigig and no Chiyuv Skila on Mezid? Lav to Mechamer, is it not? Do we not assume it's talking about this Chilul Shabbos that's learnt out here from the Pasuk of Loisasi Kol Melacha? Mechamer, it's not one of the Lamed Tes Melachas. And in this Chilul Shabbos, there's no Chatos for Shoigig and there's no Skila for Mezid. Not like Rami Bar Choma said, says the Gemara Loi. This second question we can get past. It could be talking about Tchumin at Valibud Rabbi Akiva. Rabbi Akiva holds that going, traveling past, walking beyond the Tchum is an Issa D'Oraisa. If it's an Issa D'Oraisa, it's called Chilul Shabbos. And nonetheless, even according to Rabbi Akiva, that Tchumin is D'Oraisa, somebody who goes past the Tchum, even according to Rabbi Akiva, will not be Chayev Chatos and will not be Chayev Skila. Or, V'Havara Libud Rabbi Yosi. You'll remember from Daf Ayin Omid Aleph that the Torah singles out Leisavaru Eish, not to kindle a fire. And the Gemara discusses why does the Torah single out Leisavaru Eish. According to Rabbi Yosi, the Pasuk singles it out to tell us that regarding Havara, regarding kindling a fire, there it's only a lav, and it's not like all the other Malachas that there's Chatos and Skila. Regarding Havara, lighting a fire, it's only a lav, and there's no Shoigig and Skila. So this proof from the Mishnah and Sanhedrin can be refuted this way. Rav Zvid Masniach. Rav Zvid says this whole dialogue we had with Rami Bar Choma and Rav. Rav Zvid says it a bit differently. Omar Rami Bar Choma, Hamechamer Achar Behemtoi B'Shabbos B'Shoigig Einoi Chayev Chatos. Not like we saw before in Rami Bar Choma that B'Shoigig Chayev Chatos. According to Rav Zvid, Rami Bar Choma said B'Shoigig Einoi Chayev Chatos. B'Meizit Chayev Skila. But B'Meizit, however, there is a Chiyuv Skila. Mosiv Rava. Rava is now asking a question on Rami Bar Choma. Hamechale Les HaShabbos B'Dovo Shechayovin Al Shigigosei Chatos Chayovin Al Zdoinei Skila. Somebody who's Mechalel Shabbos with something that if you do it B'Shoigeg, there's Chatos, then if you do it B'Mezid, there's Skila. And some say that it's the same Mishnah we mentioned on Kufnun Gimel Amud Beis, others say it's a Braisa. You can look in the Roshash. Ha, Ein Chayovin Al Shigigosei Chatos, Ein Chayovin Al Zdoinei Skila. It seems from there that the Chiyuv Chatos for Shoigeg and the Chiyuv Skila for Mezid always go together. Because that's what it says. Hamechalel es Hashabbos b'dovo shechayovin al shigosei chatos, chayovin al zdoinei skila. So how can you, Rami Bar Chama, say that there's no chatos for shoyge by the iskila on mezid? Says the Gemara, no, I'll answer that. Miktoni, does it actually say in that Mishnah or that Braisa, ha ein chayovin v'chulei? This that you're deducing from that quote, that if there's no chatos for shoygig, then there's no skila, that was something you deduced from that quote and may not necessarily be the truth. It could be that it is true that wherever there is a chatos, there is skila. But to say that where there's no chatos for shoygig, there's no skila for mezid, that's not something explicit. Hochi ko omar. That's true. Something that has shoygig, has chatos for shoygig, has skila for mezid. There are things that you're not chayev chatos for shoygig, and nonetheless you can be chayev skila if you do it mezid. What would that be? Mechamir. That would be the halacha that Rami Bar Chama said of mechamir bebehemtoi. In the next shiur, we're going to continue from here.